good to go, but they got a good shot, and the ball still in their possession. Maryland now working around, controlling. That's Pat Burton. He has the last goal, the one that tied it up for Maryland. As they look around, Hanley now on the far side. Looking, Burton, got two left-handers in there, two natural lefties. Of course, they go both ways. They're all very talented, but the natural hand is usually the strongest. And Pat Burton comes to that left side, looking for a break. Here's Hanley. Hanley looks at the crease, picked off by Shaker. Just as casual as you please, as he looks over help. He has 5 seconds in the crease. He backs off, looks to the wing, and now the clear with the midfield. That's Goss for UMBC.
You know, before this game, I have to be honest, I really thought Maryland was going to knock UMBC off pretty handily. You disagree. You look at the past couple games, the past couple years, you're right. Even though the University of Maryland did prevail, it's always been good games. This is kind of an Army Navy type situation where both teams, no matter how they're doing during the year, really play equally. Full of times and rivalries and all sports that happens. It doesn't matter where the teams are at a particular time of the year. They just feel good against a certain team. I think the UMBC always feels good and is up to the task of playing a good game against Maryland. The talent may not be equal, but certainly the will is. Rocky bringing up the middle, beating one man and then another as he comes in the offensive half. He sees nobody, spits him up. He wants to shoot. He will shoot. He comes in, no. Wide of the goal. He looks back to the crease. And now Goss will have to pick it up. He isn't being pressured too much, so he will settle it down. Now he is instructed to settle it down by his midfielder. As they assess, and Huff is a little bit tired, Joe. He says to Goss, slow it down, take your time. Both teams, again, they don't care if they win 12-11 or 20-11. 12-11 will be just fine. So they're taking their time, trying to make the best out of every offensive situation. Button in the perimeter, getting good pressure from Maryland.
Watching a good end zone shot now. This is what it looks like from behind the goal. It gives you a good perspective from the team, just like this is the way the player sees the game.
Starkey moving in, Starkey, 6'3", 200, good size against Jackson. There's Hockey with a good move. He's quick. And an excellent check puts the ball by Brian up front, but Goss has a cannon and a screen. They bounce off the screen, and look at the bodies clearing at the crease. Beardmore fishes it out, but a little traffic flag is passing him, but he can't quite get the ball. And there's not down. Can you know this? He could have gotten that if he could have been another goal from that. Now what time? Oh, Chris O'Brien is not picked up, going for a shot. He feeds across. Two passes. Backhanded. He does not get the shot. And here, four choice of shots for Pat Burton on the far side. Joe, he's a left-hander. He had a right-handed shot. He tried to come back to his left hand, but it didn't work out for him.
Let's take a look at it. As Shaver stops him, this would have been a great turnaround for the University of Maryland. He comes in. Bad choice, just as you said. Goalie's waiting for it. Stuffs him right there. And not only that, he'll turn around and hit a stick while he has possession, which means that UMBC gets a free clear. And that's how fast things turn in that cross. Goalie from Maryland made a good save, made a great clear, brought it up, shot on goal, stuffed, and the ball's right back to UMBC. Score all tied, 11-all.
You know, when you go backhand like that, Joe, there is no second-guessing the goalie. There's no faking. The goalie knows your only shot is a weak one, and he goes right to it. Now Starkey behind, controlling for UMBC in the way.